I'm Joanna Simpson here at Quant Finance International in London. Joining me now is Chandni Bhan, Global Chief Risk Officer at Wise. Thank you very much for joining me today.
Thank you for having me.
And natural language processing is nothing new in Quant Finance, but what are the value of large language models? What opportunities do they offer?
Not just natural language processing, but I think if you just think about models in AI in general, they've been around for a really long time. It's really the application of that in the industry that tends to lag, and I think the adoption of it now is starting to roll up faster. Where I think the opportunity is with NLP as well as other models in AI is anywhere that you're dealing with large volumes of data, or you're dealing with data at a really fast pace, so you have to make decisions very instantly, like we do at Wise in payments. A lot of the risk scoring, a lot of the thinking and the analytics needs to happen real time and needs to happen fast and a large volume of data. That's impossible without the use of these models. So I think that there's greater and greater adoption of AI and machine learning happening across the industry. But in particular on NLP, there are things that for sure there's tremendous value, at least in my space that I see. One area that we're definitely going to explore or have started thinking about is how do we use this in improving coding. Another area is how do we improve documentation and communications, particularly when it comes to contracts. Another place where this could have a huge amount of value is you have volumes and volumes of regulatory information. Is there a way to succinctly decipher the relevant pieces of information so you're able to drive action quickly against things? So there's definitely a tremendous amount of application. I think it's just a question of how quickly that it gets adopted and rolled out across the industry.
And you've touched upon it there, but how have you applied AI and machine learning techniques in Quant Finance?
In Quant Finance, I've been in the industry for over 17 years. Across my different roles in different parts of the organizations, I've used this very specifically in risk extensively. A specific product that came off the back of using AI is developing early warning signals, which I also had to talk about in general, the context of that. How do you develop cross-asset signals for your products to trade, get better timing on trade, get better on risk management, and improve outcomes for your customers in the end? Again, another place that we've used this is improving our how do we systematize our contracts with clients, especially when you have a lot of bespoke clients who come up with generic contracts that are unique in nature. How do you make sure you can build in the intelligence to get the right pieces built into your controls and into your oversight within the organization? Another place is building up AI on improving customer outcome and improving customer experience by being able to anticipate and being able to proactively understand the customer's requirements and needs and being able to put and offer the right services in line with what their expectations are. So those are a couple of examples that I can give off the bat.
And where do you see the value of AI in payments and risk in particular?
Payments is fascinating. So my jump to payments from a traditional investment bank was just because of the speed of innovation in this space. And what's really fascinating in payments is you're dealing with crazy volume of data and you're having to make decisions on the fly very, very quickly. And so the real juice of your effectiveness comes into how well you're able to model, anticipate, predict, and react in this space. And so AI plays a huge role just because you're having to make real-time decisions very, very quickly on volumes of data that are massive, and that has to drive your action. And so from payments industry, there's definitely huge room for application of AI. I think we're just at the cusp of starting it. Areas where I see it having early adoption in is fincrime, AML, TF monitoring and ability to identify scams and frauds. That's definitely ripe for the use and utilization of AI. But there's massive application of AI to be drawn on efficiencies in the organization, because cost is obviously a massive factor in consideration. So where there are processes that you can streamline, make more efficient, more intelligent, more cleaner with the use of AI, I think that's a massive win for any industry, but in particular, more so for the payments space.
Chandni Bhan, thank you very much for your time today.
Really appreciate it. It was great. Thank you very much.